All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503, live from the Oregon coast. Beautiful sunset out here. Beautiful day. I got to give first time, long time again, just regular stuff. This is from West Coast, trying to give you guys a little perspective out here about Ducks. But and we'll talk about Ducks basketball. But this, I got to start with sad news this week about an Oregon legend, Chris Bjork. Absolute legend, and passed away this week. And much love to Chris and his family. The Ducks family lost a serious one with him, and he was a part of the family for a long time and did a lot of work in a lot of varieties with Oregon Sports Network and Learfield and a lot of different other places. Chris was just a great individual. Such a fun guy to be with, and I just wanted to spend just a second kind of talking about him, because you know, I think everybody has a memory of where they were when the coronavirus hit and it really interrupted their life, like for the first time. We are 1 year out from when it shut down at the Pac-12 tournament. The Bevos just won in a miraculous game against UCLA to put this game for Oregon and Oregon State. That was the game we were expecting to see. We were in Vegas, we saw that first full day of basketball. The Beavs had a huge game, won a last second shot, and I'm literally with Chris. I'm drinking beers, we're hanging out at the mezzanine, we're watching the Arizona game, and he starts getting notifications on his phone saying, hey, they're canceling the Big Ten, they're canceling the Big 12, we're next. And literally, Chris Bjork told me that it was canceled. You know, it was a classic, where were you when this happened moment? And I was with him. And so, you know, this is really a tragic news to hear, because this guy is such a fun guy to be with. Again, like I'm saying, I met Chris probably 10 years, 12 years ago. Duck functions, coaches dinners, tailgate events, whatever the case may be, club level, and then a lot of the bowl games. You know, a lot of times we've got bowl games and be with the Duck folks and the out with the flock and whatnot. And so just got to start with that to give a couple of minutes of time for Chris, because he deserves it. And we're thinking of you, man. I'll be cracking a Coors Light for you in the future, bud. Okay, let's talk about these Ducks, because that's what Chris would want us to talk about. Duck basketball. I don't do a lot with basketball. I mainly focus on the football side of it, but you know, always got to get into it with March Madness and all. And the Pac-12 tournament is one of my favorites. We've gone to Vegas for years on this one, and it's just such a fun time down there. And really missed out on going this year. It just seems like there's a void, you know. Obviously, I'm making the best of it, but I'm playing a lot of golf, man. Social distancing still major effect out here. Shouts out to Manzanita. Golf out here, abandoned dunes, you know, best what we have out here. So anyway, let's get into this Duck thing. Chris Duarte won. Obviously the AP knows better than the writers out here, Pac-12. I think Duarte, player of the year. No offense, you know, to player of the year, you know, because, you know, the way it shapes out, you know, both guys had a great year, obviously. But both players were solid defensive players. That's, I think, most of the time when you look at, you know, the player of the year, a lot of times it's just an offensive player. In this case, you know, both sides of the ball were represented. So you got to give a love. You know, USC, they did their thing this year. I don't think a lot of people expected them to be at the spot they were. And they won a lot of the preseason or postseason awards, but I tend to think that Oregon deserve a lot of those awards just as well. So start off with that one. Chris Duarte had a great year, super solid player. I think a lot of people have talked about him, like who he reminds them of in the pros. And obviously all these guys, whenever they get compared to somebody in the pros, they get compared to like a NBA Hall of Famer, right? Not just like a journeyman player. I think a lot of these guys on the Ducks roster right now have the potential to play in overseas and whatnot and have really great careers. I don't know about the NBA for a lot of them, but I think Duarte's got an NBA career for sure. I think Eugene Amorui as well might have an NBA career. I don't know about LJ. I would love to see him get some love, but for sure, Chris Duarte, to me, reminds me of Manu Ginobili. Guys, very European style of play, very elusive player, really good defensively, good steals. That's a really thing I like to watch when I see about international play. Historically, I think the game's kind of opened up now, and there's a lot more European influence on the American game. We don't dump it down low anymore. We don't kind of rotate through like we used to. And so, you know, now we've kind of have more of an influence of the European or the international, I should say, play, not just European, international play. And Duarte really represents that very well. Great rebounder, great with the ball in his hands, smooth player, fast, strong, all the things that you need to be a successful player, I think, in the modern game. He fits the mold for sure. So shouts out to him. And then I just love Dane Altman. I mean, again, I just go back to, you know, where were you when Dana got hired and how well did you know at that point? I've been a coach for years. I've played basketball, but then as soon as I couldn't play anymore, you know, I went to coaching. So I've coached for 20 years. And, you know, I have connections with Nike and some other guys who I know. And I put in the word text message to those guys, say, tell me about Dane Altman. And they said, he's the truth. And that was it. I mean, it couldn't say it better. This guy, every single year, prints 20 win seasons. This year did it again, counting the win today. So, you know, just really amazing. Can't say enough about Dana and, you know, just having the opportunity that they have every year to be successful. I think that's tremendous. So this year been a great year. It's been really fun. I didn't do as much, like I'm saying, videos. I've been doing a lot of other stuff. You know, like I'm saying, playing a lot of golf, but other sort of stuff out there. But I just love this time of year and the Pac-12 tournament. So Ducks got a big win today, ASU. Tough to see Remy go out the way he did. I always liked Remy Martin. I thought he was a great player. One of the best Duck basketball games I've ever been to was that game down in Vegas where the Ducks played and beat ASU in that semifinal game. That was just such a fun game. And I just really appreciate his style of play and how he goes about his business. So shouts out to him. And then, you know, I think, you know, talking about, you know, player of the year, talking about UCLA and other sort of stuff, you know, I think this year was such a weird year. You know, had it played out the whole way, you know, maybe it would have been different. I think the Oregon really came on late, and obviously they've won now 10 out of 11 or whatever last. But their USC game was a real flat one, and they always kind of have one of those where, you know, out of nowhere you don't know where this is coming from, and all of a sudden here it comes. And so they had a flat game, that's fine, you know, but then they've really rebounded from that point and really, they moved the ball. You know, Dana's system is such a unique system, and I really, really depends on a lot of ball movement. You see guys, it feels like they're giving up open shots, they're trying to get a better look, and you have a lot of cutters, a lot of backside cutters as well that you're always gonna have to kind of be aware of. And, you know, these guys all 6'6", 6'7", you know, with length and speed, you know, it's just a really, really good lineup. So I'm excited to see what we got going forward in this tournament. Beav game next is going to be awesome tomorrow. So today's first day of the Pac-12 tournament, if you're not paying attention. Next day, we're going to have the Beav game. That's such a great game because that's the game that got canceled last year when we were in Vegas. So it would be cool to kind of see how that goes. Just a super exciting game with the Beavs. You know, I don't really root for the Beavs that often, obviously. Most Duck fans, right? We kind of stay in our lane with that one. But for the most part, you know, when it comes to bowl games or it comes to other sort of stuff like these tournament stuff, I always try to root for the Beavs, you know, give them a good look. So be pretty exciting to see how that goes. And then going forward, I think it's really cool to see where this program is, you know, because again, you know, March Madness this year is going to be a different deal. Everybody's going to be in the same kind of bubble. It's going to be very strange this year. And I think this team has a potential. You know, I don't know exactly. Everything's about matchups and March Madness, obviously. But this team, I think, has the potential with the senior leadership, amount of guys who have played a lot of minutes. You got three or four guys on this team that have all scored over 1,000 points in D1 basketball. So I think there's a lot of really skilled guys out here. And the more comfortable these guys get in that sort of tournament setting, I think the better they'll play. I would really, really love to see them win, you know, obviously win out this tournament would be fantastic just to kind of put a cherry on the top of this season because it's been such a tough season. I mean, to lose all those games, I mean, that UCLA game that they lost was because the refs had COVID. I mean, they were ready to play. UCLA was up here ready to play. The refs have COVID. I mean, what are you going to do with that? So this has just been a tough year, I think. You know, every coach I think has the opportunity to be the coach of the year, like they were saying on the broadcast. You know, I think that's an interesting statement. You know, this has just been such a tough year, but you know, I was really happy to see the Bees beat UCLA. I'm not a huge UCLA fan. I respect them a great deal, but it's always fun when the Ducks or the Bees can beat them. It's just the old school dominant team in the conference. You know, obviously we kind of feel the same way now with Arizona because they've been dominant for so long, and I'm assuming that other teams are now feeling that about the Ducks, because I think the Ducks lately have been the best team in the conference, and they're showing it right now. So all right guys, thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Shouts out to Terry Porter and the Portland Pilots. Give them some love too. And again, Bjork family, Chris, we'll be thinking of you. You're in our thoughts for a long time, my man. All right, guys, go Ducks.